Good morning, my name is Kenan Rajyaguru. I am teaching you moral science subject. Till now we have seen till unit 2. Unit 1 was you didn't call me and unit 2 was we are with you. So now we will start with unit 3, which is anger. So let's start. 3. Anger. So do you all know what is anger? What do you mean by anger? No, I will explain you later. Let's see the chapter first. There once was a little boy named Johnny. He had a bad temper. He used to get angry even for very minor things. His father advised him to control his anger, but he could not. So here's a little boy named Johnny. He had a short temper thing. So his father advised him to control his anger, but he could not. One day his father called him, gave him a bag full of nails, told him, "Johnny, take these nails. Every time you lose your temper, you must hammer a nail into back fence." So his father gave him task to control his anger, to get rid of his short-temperedness. So his father told him that every time you lose your temper, you have to hammer a nail into back fence. See, this is the fence and he has to hammer it, as you can see in the picture. "Yes, Daddy," said Johnny, as Johnny also wanted to control his anger. He was ready to do anything to control his anger. Johnny knew that it was not good to get angry over silly matters. So Johnny also wanted to get rid of this anger, because getting angry in silly matters is not a good thing. So he took the advice of his father seriously. Every time he got anger, he hammered a nail into the fence. On first day, he had to drive 37 nails into the fence. That means 37 times he lost his temper. So in the first day, he lost his temper like 30 times. The next day, he nailed 30 nails. So on the second day, he got anger over 30 times. Thus, the number of nails he hammered decreased day by day. So on the first day, he lost his temper 37 times. Second day, 30 times. And it kept decreasing. He found it easier to hold his temper than to drive those nails into the fence. So hammering the nails is not an easy task. He thought that I could control my temper than to hammer the nails. Finally, the day came when Johnny didn't lose his temper at all. So decreasing day by day, he was not anger over silly things. Wait a minute. Okay. He was very happy that he could conquer the bad habit of yelling and shouting. He felt that he had become a good boy. He told this to his father and his father told him, "Well done, Johnny. It is a great achievement to control your anger. Now do one more thing. Pull out one nail each day you are able to hold your anger." So now his father gave him another task. His father told him that each day passes without losing temper over silly matters, he have to pull out one nail on each day. "Yes, Daddy, I will do that." The day passed and little Johnny was able to tell his father that all the nails were removed. So time over time, Johnny was able to conquer the anger. So he also started to pull out the nails if he was not angry in a single day. So the time came when there was no nails to be removed. Now the father took Johnny by the hand and led him to the fence. He said, "You have done very well, son. You You could control your anger, but look at the holes in the fence. The fence will never be the same. When you say things in anger, they leave a scar, just like this one. So his father told Johnny that look at this fence, there is scar. So whenever you get anger and say things, they leave a scar. You put a knife in a man and draw it out, it won't matter how many times. I am sorry, the wound is still there. So you put a knife in a man and pull it out, no matter how many times. And if you say I am sorry, it won't, there still will be wound. It won't get recovered. A verbal wound is as bad as a physical one. So whenever you abuse or offend someone, it is as much as punching him or her. Sometimes we are like little Johnny. We express our anger without any control. We throw things at others and hurt them. So sometimes we are like little Johnny. We also took out anger on someone else. Shout even at our elders. We shout even if they are our elders. We cause troubles in school, our home, and even on the playgrounds because of our bad temper. Others have to suffer many times. So because of your short-temperedness, others have to suffer it. And they always leave a scar on them. In school, when students quarrel with other students and hurt them, the principal calls their parents. Poor parents, they have to come to school, leaving their work and spending money. Some of them have to take an auto rickshaw or even walk to school. Then they say sorry to the principal and teachers. Why? Because of children's issue. So whenever students quarrel, the principal has to call their parents. So sometimes parents has to take auto rickshaw, put down all the works they were doing and come to school. For the what? Because of children's anger, because they were quarreling. As the story tells, even if we say sorry 100 times, the damage cannot be removed. Because of our anger, we bring a bad name to our school and home, our teachers and parents. We destroy the happiness and peace of other people. No matter how many times we say sorry, it won't be recovered. There always will be a scar. So no matter how many times you say sorry, it won't matter. And we also destroy the happiness and peace of other people due to our anger. We yell at someone, we quarrel with, it will leave a scar always. It may be difficult to control our anger, but it is not impossible. Yes, it may be difficult. At the first, you will get a hard time to control your anger. But day by day, as if like Johnny, there will be a decreasing. Like Johnny, if we try sincerely, we will able to control our anger. So like the Johnny did, you can always control your anger. It's always remember that anger is just one letter short of danger. So from the danger, you remove the D. So it becomes the anger. So anger is just one letter short of danger. Anger always brings the danger. Whenever you are angry, you are not the only one who get hurt. Other people get hurt too. Like mentioned in the story, you always leave these scars. Because of your quarrel, your teacher and principal has to call your parents, and your parents has to come to the school without any reason, because of your short-temperedness. Actually, not without any reason, but yes, your anger is not really a reason for them to leave their work and spend money because of your anger. So I'm saying that without any reason. So you must try to control your anger. Exercise. Answer the following question. What did Johnny's father him to do when he got angry? So what did Johnny's father advise him to do? Yes, to hammer the nail into the back fence. Number 2, what remained on the fence even after the nails were removed? So what remained on the fence? Scar. Scar remains on the fence. What happens when we say things in anger? So what happens when we say things in anger? It always leaves a scar. Number 4. Name the different things we do when we express our anger without any control. So you have to name the different things we do when we express our anger without any control. What is the result of our bad temper? The result of our bad temper is it can get hurt not only to ourselves but also to our close one or someone else, and it will hurt the happiness and peace of other people. Filling the blanks. So there is the filling the blanks. There are 3 given. I will share the answer of answer the following question and filling the blanks in the PDF. Okay, that's all for today. So always remember to control the anger. So now you also know the meaning of anger. What is anger and how bad is it? Anger is just a feeling, but you must know how to control it. Okay, thank you.